how did you get into the business, and how did you find your way into this whole marketing world?
So it's a story that actually starts my freshman year in college. I was taking a rhetoric class, and one of the assignments was to find a popular brand advertising campaign and argue, was it good for society or not? And out of 20 people in the class, I was the only person to argue that the campaign for Crest toothpaste, which I chose, was actually good for society because the sales funded the investment and the research into fluoride and better products, et cetera, et cetera. So when I figured out I was one against 19, I thought, well, maybe something's here. So I pursued a degree in marketing as well as a background in philosophy and English. And I was very fortunate to be hired as one of the 10 hirees for Leo Burnett in 1987 when I got out of college. So I actually started at Leo, and the idea was to be part of the client service track. But I stayed in media and didn't go on to Leo because I really felt like media was where it was at. It was changing, it was dynamic, you could begin to see the forces at work changing the way people consumed media and changing their behavior and the relationship to it. And also the forces in the industry where creative wasn't the first thing, the middle thing, and the only thing. It was part of a conversation with media, and reaching people at the right time and the right place became as important, and I think arguably today, 20 years later, more important than the message itself. And so that's how I got started, and that's why I stayed.
Why would you advise a young person to go into this kind of career, this business?
So I think our work inherently is for people who are young or young at heart. Because you have to have a constant curiosity around the world and for what's going on around you and how people are changing their behavior and living their lives and how you connect brands to that behavior. So you really have to be very comfortable with this notion of following people, their pace, their purpose, and moving at what I think is an increasingly faster rate of velocity as we see technology and empowerment really just disrupt, you know, business models in the media industry today, and we're watching people have power and control over things that they never had power and control over.
You've been with this business for a while, you've seen a change. Tell us about, you know, your journey, your setbacks.
I've always learned more from failure than success. And I think at times when people, you know, are on the top of the wave and riding it and feeling like they're, you know, nothing can touch them, you know, those are the points in time where you have to really remember, boy, what was it like to be off that wave or in that valley or in a point where you weren't sure what to do? And I think those times make you humble and they keep you hungry and they keep you focused on the good and the necessary learning and the necessary challenges that go into staying strong in this industry. This industry ain't for the faint of heart. I mean, it's a tough business today. Lots of different pressures, tech, consumer change, disruption of models, models breaking apart, the forces of purchasing and procurement on our business, the optimization of Fortune 500 companies that have built iconic brands over the last 100 years and now growth is slowing for them. You know, we sit in the center of all that. It ain't an easy business, but you know, throughout my 20 years, this whole notion of being in things that are in situations and areas that are more challenging or not as easy as kind of prepared me for this as well.
In your travels, in your journey, have there been any mentors for you?
I mean, the truth of the matter is I've learned from everybody. I mean, I really have. I mean, the great bosses, the crappy bosses, the good clients, the challenging clients, I've learned from everyone. And I've always just taken it as an opportunity when somebody's smart and you get a chance to spend time, ask questions. Don't just sit there and sort of like, you know, fake your way with the legends of the industry. You know, ask questions, lean in, find out experiences that they had that really helped them learn and grow, and in turn how I could learn from that. So I've never really had one person. I've just had a series of great events and great experiences where I've just taken the point of view of, I get to work in an amazing business where I can spend time with the CEOs of all the media companies, the founders of all the DigiGo companies, The people who are shaping the industry in terms of ad tech and VCs, learn from them all and be humble and listen. You know, that's really mostly what I've tried to do.